gave us your tandan. Yaluba standan is lale matunge. Ndibanjwangue. Yaluba standan is lale matunge. Nguwe lo. Yaluba standan is lale matunge. Denzi wangue. Yaluba standan is lale matunge. Bazali bam ndibizele ndinomfuna
spirit. No statistic can put that human experience in a box and tell you how life is going to be. There is no doubt in my mind that we can have 100% pass at this school, 100% exemption in the school, and 100% graduation at the end. There's no doubt in my mind. The difference, you have already shown you can get this far. Why can't you get further? Why? The only difference between where you are now and where you will be is your perseverance. Okay? That is the first thing I'm going to say.
Social life, boyfriends, family, have a 30-minute conversation with mama just to ask if she's fine and everything, but you have to be studying every day because the finals is the last straw, right? And I hope you did well in grade 11 because you know that universities consider your grade 11 marks when you guys are applying.
There's a huge gap between high school and varsity, but trust me, it's all worth it. Every single bit of it, every single sleepless night when you're studying for a test and exam, it's all worth it. So you guys should study hard and be proud.
But your marks will pay your fees. That's what is true. When you get to master's, it's not about. When you get to master's, it's not about. You see, I'm going to lie. If you want your parents to pay your master's fees, it's not really going to work out. Just make sure, even if you are rich, maybe you're going to open a cafe like that every day in school. It doesn't work. Yeah. Make sure that you work hard. Because master's fees, like, when I was, last year, my fees alone were 96,000 without food. So if I wanted food, and first of all, there's a rest where you pay 55,000 a year without food. If you want food, you can pay 85,000. Rest alone. If you're doing medicine, medicine is like 85,000. It means a year is 200,000. So that means your parents can actually buy AMG every year. When I want to, so it's make sure you study hard. It's all up to you. It's not up to someone else. It's all up to you. What people are telling you, it has nothing to do with you. If you want that thing, you're going to get it. If you want to be a baby-making women, you want 50 women, children, it's fine, you can do that. If you want to drive an AMG, it's fine, you can do that. And then that's the truth. It's up to you. If you don't want to go to university, it's up to you. But you need to know what is it that is bringing back. Because you know that when you don't apply, what's going to happen to you next year? I want to go to Vanya, I know, when you want to go to the school to or go to Cape Town. People literally go, nowadays, some people even get accepted to go Cuba. They leave the country. And I said, so it's up to you what you want. If you want to work, go to a private status, it's up to you. But ask yourself, what is it that is beneficial? Is it beneficial to sit at home all the time? Is it beneficial to be lazy and one generation scandal and know who's who? It's nothing like that. But it's beneficial to sit down and read your books.
Second thing I'm going to say is, one of your greatest challenges is going to be money. Let's not lie. You're sitting here thinking, how am I going to afford? Let me give you an opportunity here. If you have a phone that can use the internet, I would like you to download this app called WeChat. It's like a WhatsApp app. When you're on WeChat, I will leave this here for you. Look for this thing called Money for Jam. It will allow you to earn an income answering questions on your phone. And it will help you pay for your application fee. I have students who are earning 200 rand a month using this thing on their phones. Right? And they're paying for themselves, not only food for home, but for the application fee. I will leave this here for you, and I will answer any questions. That's the second.
How bad do you want it? You know, how bad were that do you want to be where she is? You know, where someone you know is? Or all pictures will say that, you know, or even the t-shirts. You know, how bad do you want it when it's in the future? There's this story, this guy, he was very rich, a guru. Then this young man, Abayakwe, and other, you know what, master, I want to be rich like you. Please teach me how to make money. And then this guy was like, okay, meet me at the beach in the morning. And then I was like, beach, no, I don't want to be a lifeguard. Why don't you get to the beach? I don't know. Meet me at the beach at 4 in the morning. So this guy comes over now. This guy comes for eating dressed like this, instead of dressing short, you know. And then the master was like, how bad do you want it? About real bad. And then he said, walk, move it in one. And then he went, about no, come waist deep. After meeting, about no, come fed until meet after come. And then he started doing this, excuse me. He started doing this to him. And this guy was fighting, and then Amon said, okay, in that moment, what did you want to do? In that moment, I was in the ground. The only thing I was thinking about is breathing. In that moment. So when, in this moment, Fernando, nothing else matters. Your background now matters not. It's not an excuse. It's not. You can't make your where you come from an excuse for that. It can be excused right now because we've got an opportunity. It's how bad do you want it? If you don't want bad, you don't want it bad enough to go to sleep at 2 o'clock, or now it's going to go to take a nap, or 6 o'clock. That was my strategy. 6 o'clock, I sleep until 10, because I know for the watching generations, how about everyone? Wake up, light, and then study. You know, but I did it over and over again. It was sacrifice, it was painful, but at the end of the year, had the results beat you. He checked up on his paper. My name was there, Mr. B. It was there, and I smiled. I didn't cry. You know, some people cry, it's okay to cry, but I smiled because I knew it. Was effort. That is between you and you.
My degree, my first degree was 3 years. I did it in 4 years. I had to repeat my final year. But I didn't say to myself, no, I'm a failure, no, you know what, let me just leave. I didn't do that. I went back. Pride aside, whoever saying what, you know what other people say about you is none of your business. What other people say about you is none of your business. It's about when you're sleeping at night and when you're sitting and you're alone. How good do you feel about your life? How good do you feel about the choices that you make? Think about it. Today when you get home and you sit down and you think about the choices that you've made, how proud of you are you of yourself? Don't think about whether your parents are proud of you for a moment, or your friends, or your uncles, your aunts. Think about how proud are you of yourself right now? Because at the end of the day, your parents, whether it's a sad thing, they will leave you here. Your friends, some of them, you will never get to see them again. You'll have different paths. Fine, they're your friends, you love them. But then they also have their own life to live. You have to start living your own. You have to start molding your own. Because when you're 50 and you're actually, you're thinking, I could have been a doctor. I could have been living in a mansion. You'll be looking back and saying, yeah, but you know, Joyful was the one who made me do this.
No, Joyful might have put it on the table, but you had a choice to reject it.
If you know you want to study today, go and study. Whether your friends are with you or they're not with you, go and study. Because at the end of the day, it's you that's coming out of that newspaper. It's you that's either getting an F or an A. Not your friend. It's all about you and how you actually view yourself and where you want to be. Like they said, if you want to live in a mansion one day, you can't go and actually just decide to just walk through life without working hard. Everywhere you go, you're going to find problems. That's a fact.
I'm not going to talk for very long, but I want to say something to you very powerful, very powerful. That one day someone will ask you, what is your story? Tell me your story. Maybe you're sitting at home. What is your story? And I want you to start writing that story today. When you meet yourself in 5 years, time, let's say you could meet yourself, what would that person tell you? If I met myself 8 years ago, when I was at this school, working with these learners there, I would have said to myself, I hope when I come back there's classrooms, there's a car park, there's a toilet.
How much these guys are very much passionate to give back, to say we didn't have this opportunity when we were growing up. Ask all of them, if went to a matrix, someone came to this voluntarily, to say, here I am, I'm going to return, hold your hand and say, take your matrix very seriously. This is an application, this is everything else. Ask them, none of them have that opportunity. But today they are very much passionate about doing all those kind of things. They don't even sleep. They even leave their own. I mean, today it's Thursday. And no more student has to be in class. They've met their class, they've met their lecturers and all those kind of things. So on those bases, I hope you are going to actually sit down, evaluate the decision you make in life, and realize that there are people out there who are willing to sacrifice everything that they have for me. What I'm saying for me, I mean for you. Yeah, I hope you understand that one. So, please, guys, don't disappoint me. I don't know if next day I'm going to come back here again. But then, you know, this kind of thing is besides discourage someone else to say, look, let me pack up my bags and go to the very same place and then get the kind of reaction that you get. Am I clear, guys? The principal, speak to the principal for us to know, in fact, you are going to keep your weight and do this one. Because otherwise, I mean, the whole of next day I can go to KZN, go to Eastern Cape, and not come here. Thanks.
Teacher, not your mother, you can't blame them. Because when our young people, 2 weeks ago I was doing my practicals, you know, I buried 2 young kids because of suicide. Bamuchiki and she committed suicide. Olene Arubala, boyfriend in Bamuchiga, and she committed suicide. You know, because that's how young people are today. Abarugoena, Tibanen, Oscar this, or then we can't buy you a cell phone, we can't get you this. You start throwing 10 pounds. And then you go and kill yourself. But you don't know what you're killing when you're killing yourself. You don't know who Musa Simona, the future, the president of this country, can be Musa Simona. Man, how be president there? Who's not supposed to be there, but like a president? It doesn't happen like that. It takes time, sacrifice, making sure the friends, you don't need 200 friends, 3 people, 4 people, about the Kutusa, those are the people who will carry you. Those are the people when you look back in your life, you're like, yes, that's far, you've been with me. People usually ask me when you look back, but when I look back, what I see, it's front, the chalkboard corner. There's no back. I can tell you, I see you. So there's, you can't say I'm gonna look back. There's no back. Everywhere you face becomes your front. Everywhere. So now this is your front. The final lap of your life. So you've got the key.
Because they're not gonna give it to you. Your friend right next to you is not gonna hand you a degree and say, here's the degree. Not gonna hand you that house that you want, not gonna hand you the car that you want. You have to go out there and get it yourself. The world doesn't owe you anything. You have to make your way here. As tough as it might be, right now you might not want to admit it. Right now you still want to be mama's little girl, daddy's little girl, daddy's little boy, and everything. You're still under the protection of the school, the teachers, and everything. But once you are done here and you leave, you will see what reality has.
Okay. My sister once told me, "Metik, get key." So it depends on you. When I get to key, if you pass out a high certificate, then meet another guy, FET. And if you go to FET or grab boyfriend at FET, or grab any medical or qualify for FET, or grab a lawyer qualify for FET, that means you're going to need the FET left for the rest of your life. So that means it's a broke life in you. Then there's a second one, yeah. If you go grab a diploma, it's a key or a diploma only open FET and maybe taking the cons and stuff like that. That means every life you're going to live is going to be limited. But if you get a bachelor, you know that a bachelor opens everywhere. You can go to university. If you don't want to go to university, you can come to technical, you can also come to equity. So make sure that you get a key, you're able to learn people. Make sure you study for to get a bachelor. Because when you get a bachelor, it opens everything. When there are buzzer application, that bachelor opens and you get a buzzer. When you want a rest, that bachelor opens and you get a rest. When you, after graduating, when you want a university job, that degree open to get a proper job. Understand? That people who are earning, like they're starting now. They're earning 33,000. But what are you, there are people like CEOs that will leave, but they're earning 1 million a month. So those people started from far. Understand? So it's all up to you what you want to do. So make sure you think about something that's positive and there's something that's going to benefit you, then you do it.
I hope. And it's become a reality. Because here I am today. That's just for the school. What about your life? One day we're going to write your story. What are we going to write? And like these people have all said, it is up to you to put pen to paper and write a success story, not a tragedy. Thank you.
A psychologist, so give a couple of supporters and then look at
you.
I'm not because I'm not.
Right.